Some corrections, I haven't get my bachelor, master and the PhD degree in 2011. It was last century, 1985. So, since then, teaching. Okay, so, as our chairman, Sim School chairman, Dr. Krishna already informed you, we organized 3 days pre-Sim School to provide you by some basic knowledge on to understanding main Sim School material. So today I start from mostly I will provide the algebra part. Then today, two lectures. One on video group theory. Another lecture concerns ring theory. Let's start the first part. Material, because the time is too short, so I will give more examples rather than theoretical proving and other things. So that's why it's you can see a lot of examples. Topics, groups, subgroups, group homomorphisms, and question groups. These are four topics I will present because they are basic on understanding of groups. Okay, this is a definition of group. What is a group? A group is a non-empty set where binary operation is given. Binary operation is function from G cross G into G. So you have G cross G into G. Any such kind of function defines binary operation. And for this set, for this binary operation to be a group, it must satisfy these three conditions. First condition is to be associative, to simplify notation, we denote this function by star. So further, f g1, g2, is written as a g1 star g2 or just g1 dot g2 and understanding this is operation, binary operation on set G. So this binary operation must satisfy associativity condition, must exist such specific element which is called identity, such that for any element of G, A star E means A is E star A. This axiom is called existence of identity. Next condition is for any A, must be another element of G, such that A times B, so I start to use times, A times B is B times B times A, which is identity which we require in part 2. So if non-empty set with this binary operation satisfying this two condition, we call G star is a group. If there exists identity, then it is unique. It's easy to see. If the inverse is exists, if number three false, then the inverse of each element is also is unique. So that's why this B, we can denote the B minus 1, which is the inverse of B. Here, example start. So first example is expression of this form. Addition operation is given as component wise. So A1 square root of 2. A1 B1 square root of 2. A2 square root of 2. Add them, you will come again to expression of that form. Multiply, multiplication operation. For these two, you have A1, A2 plus 2 times B1, B2. This is the rational part. Plus the irrational part. The irrational part is A1, B2 plus A2, B1 square root of 3. Here. So with respect to this, Q square root of 2, within of Q square root of 2, a set of such expressions, then with respect to this addition operation is equal. With respect to this operation, it is not group. The reason is you have 0 here, for that there is no inverse. So that's why it's not group. To make it group, you should exclude the 0 point. 0 plus 0 square root of. If exclude, then the result again, you have a group. The group is commutative if your binary operation is commutative. A times B is B times A. Identity is 0 plus square root, 0 square root of 2 for addition operation. For multiplication operation, identity is 1 plus 0 square root of 2. Again, you see expression of this form. The inverse for addition operation is minus e plus minus b square root of 2. For multiplication operation is the inverse. Of course, it should be non-zero. This non-zero provides you for this denominator not to be zero. So that's why you can divide by a square minus 2 times b square. So a over a square minus 2 times b square minus b over a square minus 2 times b square square root of 2. This is the inverse of a plus b square root of 2. In this case, a plus b square root of 2. So in plus, we use additive writing, so that's why I will put here minus. It is the expression of this form, a plus minus b square root of 2 additive. So for this inverse, a plus b square root of 2, which is not 0, minus 1 is a rational part. A is a squared minus 2 times b squared plus the rational part minus b over a squared plus 2 times, or minus 2 times b squared square root of 2. So these two are rational numbers, so that's why this expression on this form. So this is a group. Another example of group is a power set of any set X. Then operation is given by this so-called symmetric difference operation. Delta B is A minus B union B minus B. Easy to see again, PX with respect to this operation delta is commutative group B. So here in example, which is called symmetries, all symmetries of fixed set X. It is group with respect to composition operation, because all bijections.
Can you hear me? Can I use that black whiteboard? Because this some of you cannot see that. Okay? So this is symmetries of X. Sx is F is bijection. All bijections are denoted as sub X. So with respect to star operation, which is just composition. Because composition of bijections, again, bijections, this is not fun from simple algebra. Here is another example. Rigid symmetries of square. Which kind of symmetries do you have? You have diagonal symmetries, both diagonal, mean diagonal, and skew diagonal symmetries, which is given. This way again, these two symmetries with respect to half of a square reflection, this reflection. So it denotes, this symmetry is denoted as D1, this is a D2, this is a H, this is a U. So result of combination of these symmetries, you will get such a group rotation to 360 R 360 then 90 R 90 R 180 R 270. This is another three reflections. Then result, if you combine them, start to take a combination of these symmetries, result you will get such a set. This set, these elements of symmetries of square, here is products. These kind of tables are called tables of multiplication of group. For each element of group, you will give image of this function. What will be image of that function on G? So this is a table of multiplication for symmetries of square. Symmetries of square. So result, you can see product, this one, and so on is given. So result, you will get such kind of product. If we denote alpha, denote this way, beta D2, then alpha squared is 180, and the cube 270, and so on. So result, you will get such kind of group. This is a cyclic part, then beta is multiplied by beta, all this cyclic part. This kind of group, you will see later on, this is called symmetric group of order 4. Oh, sorry, dihedral group of order 4. So, rigid symmetries of square, set of rigid symmetries of square is dihedral. So, which kind of groups do we have? Since we have commutativity, if number of elements of group is finite, then we have finite group. So, with respect to these two, you can classify groups first. So commutative finite groups, non-commutative finite group example. commutative infinite groups and the non-commutative infinite groups, for example. No, there are many, but few of them are given here. So Zn is congruous classes of smart n. Congruous class smart n, you know this from your algebra course. 0, 1, 2, and so on, n minus 1. Each of these elements are subsets of Z, plus minus 1, or plus minus n, plus minus 2n, and so on. This is 1. And this subset of Z is dividing those integer numbers, dividing by n, you will get remainder 1, remainder 2, and so on. Here, remainder n minus 1 keys. Operation is given by using operation, usually integer numbers. You have two class, A class, B class, and a result of this operation is A plus, B class. This operation is well-defined because what does it mean, well-defined for that function? It's for each pair from here, one element, such kind of pair, you should assign unique element of G. But here, since the result of your operation is defined by representatives, so you should prove that this operation doesn't depend on choice of representatives. So indeed, this operation doesn't depend on representative. If you take any another representative which represent this class, another representative which represent this class, then the result, according to this definition, must be A prime plus B prime. But you can prove these two classes are the same. In reality, may be different, but by using congruences, you can change it to C. These two things are the same, so that's why this operation doesn't depend on representative. By the way, here you can define again multiplication operation. So one thing is, important thing is, we don't know too much. See, we know only how to add real numbers, how to add rational numbers, how to multiply them, nothing else. You don't know how to multiply matrices. You express matrix multiplication or matrix addition operation to addition and the multiplication of usual real numbers. So that's why such kind of function for matrices is not defined directly. The function f for matrices is expressed by using addition in the multiplication operation of usual numbers. It's the same I do here. This expression, how to add these two expressions, you don't know. But you know how to add any two real numbers or any two rational numbers. So you will take this rational number, you add, result you will write as a rational part. Then you take these two rational numbers, add, and rewriting it, square root of 2, you will get an irrational part. So that's general for algebra. We don't know so much. We know only addition and multiplication of numbers only. All other things we will bring to that addition and multiplication of equation. A division of anything. Okay. Now, this is with respect to addition is a group easy to prove. What is the UN? UN is that this is UN is invertible elements of Cn with respect to multiplication operation, right? Just now I mentioned you can define in multiplication operation as well. How do you define multiplication? You take class A, class B, B multiplied, them as follows. You will take A and B. This is usual multiplication. This is usual addition. This is usual multiplication operation. Multiplying representatives, then the result you will then get class. So with respect to this multiplication operation, this is not group, again. Similar to that, rational numbers. But with respect to this operation, part of Zn is a group. With respect to addition, multiplication operation, there are some elements of this are invertible. So those elements are, those elements form a group. So that group is denoted U and invertible elements of Zn. C for Za, they are 1, 3, 5, and 7. You can write this for any Zn. Let me write. Those classes from Zn such that A and N are relatively prime. One class representative of that is relatively prime. N is invertible. So 1 is invertible, 3 is invertible, 5 is invertible, 7 is invertible. Why? Because these three representatives are relatively prime with 8. So that's why they are invertible. So that's why Z 8 star is 1, 3, 5, and 7. Here also this is the N star. So here UN is with respect to this multiplication operation. Non-commutative finite groups. Permutations group Sn on n symbols. All bijections in previous one of our examples. In this example, if you take x, if you take 1, 2, 3, and so on, n, then instead of this, they will write Sn. All bijections from this set into itself. This by the set of such kind of bijections is denoted by Sn. Again, it is a group with respect to composition. So which is given here? That is Sx, where x is this set. Dn, so what is Dn? Again, directly, formally, you can write as follows. Dn, it is a cyclic part of Dn, and that part which generated by that cyclic part. Dn is identity alpha, alpha square, and so on, alpha to the power n, then beta, beta alpha, and so on, beta alpha to the power n. You can easily see group is not commutative. Finite non-commutative group. Sn also has n factorial elements, but the composition operation is not commutative. No, 1, 2, and n. Since alpha to the power n 1, you know, I can delete this. Thank you. Just because alpha to the power n is e, so alpha to the power n is your beta you will get here. Okay? Just put here alpha minus 1 and j beta. Thank you. Okay. So, commutative infinite groups. And C, with respect to addition operation, your old friend. Q also, with respect to addition operation. RC, with respect to addition operation. Q without zero, with respect to multiplication. All these without multiplication, but matrices with respect to addition operation. N by N matrices, with respect to addition operation. But to be infinite, K must be infinite. Any infinite set, okay, you can take some of them. C, Q, R, C. Then the result will be infinite commutative group. Now, non-commutative infinite group example. Of course, since you have non-commutative, in matrices you have non-commutative. So G, L, and K, with respect to multiplication, K is a field. Okay, you may understand it is real numbers, complex numbers, rational, or any field. SLN, ORN, special orthogonal group, symplectic group. This is a quaternion. Quaternion group with respect to multiplication again. Non-commutative infinite group. Okay. And now, a subgroup. What is a subgroup? Well, you have group and its part. Its part. You may ask question, can we, if I restrict that function, my function, I have this function from G cross G into G. So you have part of G, here also part of G. You can consider cross product. Then, now you can consider function G, which is F restricted to H cross H. Now, question is, with respect to this restriction, do we get again, element of H or not? If yes, then of course you taking this function, start to verify that three conditions. So first condition, which important is the image of this restriction must be in H. Once you get it, then start to verify that three conditions. So the subgroup, H is called subgroup, if this restriction image is in H, plus that three conditions hold, then H is called subgroup. Shortly speaking, H is subgroup if it is a group with respect to operation which is defined on group. So that is a subgroup definition. The very interesting observation is if you have, because this is a independently subgroup, means you have identity here and identity here. The interesting thing is if you take identity here, then that is the same which identity of G itself. So identity of your subgroup with respect to this restriction and the identity of initial big group are the same. You can take that identity, use it as a identity for A. So that's why this gives you information. Subgroup must contain identity of a group. The first thing to verify for subset to be subgroup, look at identity element of group among that element of each. If the identity is there, then start to verify. That is some sign for group, for subset to be subgroup. Other properties, of course, you will check. Okay, this is groups and subgroups. This is trivial group. C, Q, R, and then C. Any left side subset with respect to operation are subgroups of right side group. So 0, Z, Q, R, C. Here 1, you see, because with respect to multiplication is identity is 1, so this is trivial subgroup. Q without 0, R without 0, and C without 0. There is no Z without 0 because not all elements of C is invertible. 2C is not invertible. Now you can see here, 0 in here, identity 0 is here, 0, 0, 0, everywhere 0 is there. Once you start to talk on subgroup. Here some, so what should you do? You should take subset. For this subset to verify to be subgroup, what should you do? You will take this function, restrict it to H cross H, then C image. Look at the image. The image is in are they in H or not? If yes, start to verify that three conditions. Very boring. So they say you can simplify this process. What you will do is use this theorem. If you have non-empty subset, if you have group, if you have group G, in some non-empty subset there,